They're so lucky, but I'll never achieve that. They have a beautiful house, a great relationship, and I'll just stay single the rest of my life. Comparing ourselves. Why are we undervaluing ourselves and overvaluing others? Trust me, I've been so guilty about comparing myself to others. Here's the honest truth. Comparing yourself can either make you feel completely miserable and stuck, or it can help you grow and make you really happy. And so I learned how to turn that comparisonitis around and make it work for me and learn the advantages of it and know how to use it so that I can grow, so that I can succeed. And that is what I want to share with you in this video. If you landed on my channel, then you know I make new videos every single Wednesday and go live every single Friday to answer your questions about escaping your job, escaping your 9-to-5, and living a freedom lifestyle. And I would have never thought that a few years ago, when I was still doing my 9-to-5, working in an office, working for a boss, that I could have that freedom lifestyle. And I was looking at other people and I was jealous and I envied them. And I thought, wow, they have that freedom. They do what they love. They're so happy, and I will never make it because I'm not good enough. Who am I? How can I start an online business? How will I make money? How can I live that lifestyle? I'm gonna have to work for a boss the rest of my life until I retire. But that's not true, because here I am. I'm now walking in the south of Italy, and this is part of my full-time travel. I am now officially a digital nomad, and I travel the world, and I choose this location for 2 months and then another location for maybe 2 or 3 months, and then I just continue traveling the world because I was able to use comparison to my advantage. I was able to take the right steps in the right direction and focus on my journey so that I could achieve this, and so that now I can help other people achieve this freedom lifestyle. If you haven't done so already, then please hit that like button, hit the subscribe button right below, and thank you for your support. Not only did I suffer comparison or comparisonitis, but I researched it, I overcame it, I made a whole TEDx talk about it, I wrote about it in my book about confidence, and boy, do I feel so much happier, you know, not comparing myself and finding my own way and my own journey. By the way, I'm just looking, I just found actually some fig trees here. I had no idea. They're right here behind me. This is so fun. I'm just discovering new things here. Comparison. Yeah, why is the grass greener on the other side, and what can you do about it? Is it just watering your own grass more? No, there's so much more to this. So comparison, why are we doing it? Well, we're human beings. We're human beings, and we are used, you know, from childhood, like, you know, when you were having your grades at school, it's like, hey, how much do you have? And how much do you have? And, you know, you compare yourself to others. We compare ourselves to our siblings, you know, maybe you are born and maybe you are raised and you were told like, oh, your brother is so much better than you. Oh, you know, or, you know, or you're doing this better than him or than her. I mean, we do it all the time. We're human beings. This is human nature. So there's absolutely nothing wrong with you. Before I explain what you actually can do to turn it around and use to your advantage, I want you to understand that what comparison really is comparing the external of others to our internal threats. What do I mean? Ooh, they have so much money, but I'm not good enough. Oh, they have such a successful business, but I'm not confident enough to do that. Oh, they're just so amazing and they're so lucky, but you know, I don't have the talents, I don't have the skills. See, we compare all of the external to our inside. So that's not logical at all. That's one of the reasons why, wait a minute, it makes no sense to compare yourself. There's no logic. You're comparing apples with oranges. Even if you would have an identical twin, you still grow up with different experiences, different friends, different situations, different likes, different dislikes. It makes no sense to compare yourself. Another reason why it makes us feel so stuck and so miserable is because we are in a place of called the focus gap. So when we focus on the gap, or in other words, we focus on the lack, we focus on what we don't have. See, if you're here right now and you're in an office, in a 9-to-5, you're working for a boss, and what you desire is way up there. It's freedom, it's financial freedom, it's doing what you want, when you want, where you want, you know, exactly the things that I'm doing right now. But the gap, and I remember this vividly, like I was in an office job, I'm like, whoa, I want that, but here I am, I'll never get there because the gap is way too big. And then you start thinking, oh, I want that, but I don't have the freedom. I don't have the finances. I don't have the right contacts. I don't have that luck. I don't have, but I want. And it's like your neck is gonna start hurting. So you focus on the lack, but remember the saying that I often say, lack of evidence is not evidence of lack. And I really had to hammer this in and really understand it. Lack of evidence is not evidence of lack. It's not because you lack those things and the financial freedom and the goals and the dreams that you have. It doesn't mean because you don't have it now that you cannot have it. Because you can create that future. That's why I made a video, you know, how do you predict your future? By creating your future. And I explain more about that in that video. I'll put the link right below and I'll link to it in the card. But I really want you to understand that you can create your future, and having that lack, if you focus on the lack, you get more of what you lack. Like where your focus goes, your energy flows. If you focus on the negative, you attract more negative. If you focus on the positive, you attract more positive. But it's not that just that, it's more than that. If you focus on the things you don't have, you're only focusing on your weaknesses, and we're so good in focusing on our weaknesses. Ooh, I'm not confident, and I don't have the right self-esteem, and I I'm not a good communicator, and I'm not a good listener, and I'm not good in relationships, and I'm not good in networking, and I'm not good in social events, and I'm not good in so many things, and we focus on our weaknesses. We're really good in our weaknesses, but what about your strengths? I want you to start focusing on your strengths. And the last thing I want to say before I explain how to turn it around is that we are all unique human beings. We are all unique human beings. Whether you believe it or not, you have unique gifts, you have unique talents, and I want you to focus on those. Start today by making a list of all the things that you have achieved. You know, it doesn't always have to be a reward or an award or a degree, but maybe you're a good cook, maybe you're good in music, maybe you're a good mom, maybe you're a good sister, I don't know. But there's so many things that you're good at. Focus on those and do that every single day. Journal about it. All right, so what can you do about comparing yourself? Well, first of all, stop it. Like seriously, stop comparing yourself. Well, how do you do that? Well, you hold up a mirror, you look at yourself like, and you look at how unique you are. So in order to stop yourself, you have to be aware of it, okay? So if you're looking at somebody else thinking, wow, you know, they have it all, they're so lucky and I don't have it, and catch yourself. When you're scrolling down on your phone and looking at social media and looking at these beautiful holidays and relationships and pictures, remember, we all have bad days. We all have bad days, but we hide our mess and we show our best. We show our best, but we all have bad days. You, me, everyone, all those great people they see on social media. But you're not gonna post a picture in your pajamas and feeling miserable or sick. You know, that's social media, you know? So be aware that everybody has good days and bad days. Be aware that the grass is not greener on the other side, but catch yourself when you're comparing yourself. Catch yourself, stop yourself, and then look at yourself. So stop and look at yourself, and then, hey, I'm actually good in communicating. I'm good in speaking. I'm a great sister. I'm actually good in organizing stuff. I'm good in planning. I'm good in meeting new people. I'm good in finding my way. And then you just focus on that. That's really key. Now, what else can you do to make comparison work in your advantage, to grow your business, to grow yourself? Well, instead of comparing yourself like, oh, they're so lucky and they have it all, and then you come from a place of lack and you stay stuck. And by the way, if you're really stuck and you want 7 steps to become unstuck and to really, you know, make a shift and a transformation in your life, I made a 7-step video training, which I will link down below. It's free. It's completely free, but it will really help you in that first stage of, okay, I want to change my life. I want to transform my life. This is it. I'm going to do it. The way you can compare yourself is by being inspired by others. You have no idea how many people send me messages and like, oh, Rachel, you're so lucky. I want that too. You have a freedom lifestyle. I want that too. Talk to me and let's see how you can achieve that. So what I'm saying is, no matter what your goal is, no matter what you want to achieve, if you are looking at people who are doing that, be inspired by them and say to yourself, wow, they have that, I can have that too. Instead of saying, they have it, I can't, I'm not good enough. No, they have it, I can do that too. The moment I made that shift while I was still in my corporate, I made the shift like, they can, so can I. And I started being inspired and I looked more and more to these people. I searched for these people that were living the life that I wanted. And I talked to them, I connected with them, I became inspired and motivated, and I took action and I took steps. And that's what I want you to do. Instead of like, oh, damn it all and I don't have anything. No, I want you to be inspired. Use that inspiration, use it as motivation, as strength, because if they have it, so can you. If I can do it, so can you. I'm helping my clients to transform their lives, to get out of the office. Within 6 months, I'm also going to launch a new group program. So we are all in the same group and we're all the same, you know, we're having this goal of, you know, stop working for a boss and just, you know, realize and make your own vision and your own goal. And then, you know, creating the steps so that you can actually say, hey, boss, I'm out of here. And trust me, it's happening more than you think. But it's only the few who are really prepared to take action, to take steps, and to move forward. Those are the ones who achieve it. And I want that for you. I really want that for you. So comparing, stop it. Turn around, look at yourself, and use others to inspire you, to motivate you. And if you want to talk to me and you're inspired by me, please do. I'm happy to help you. We hop on a call and I can share steps that will help you grow and succeed and live a freedom lifestyle. Remember to check all the links right below, comment, hit the like, hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you next week. And also, don't forget my Friday Lives. You can ask me anything on a Friday Lives. Bye.